Welcome students for today's class. Today we are going to see the concept of generalization and inheritance. The first thing will be, now what do you mean by generalization? So it is a relationship, as I have written here, it is a relationship between whom the relationship you are going to build up. The relationship will be in between your superclass and your subclass. So the whenever you are writing something, like you can say, take the example of your like parent and child. So the parent will be the superclass and the subclass will be the child. So you can have the idea like whatever the concept of inheritance is having, the same concept is generalization will also have. No, it's not like that. There is a difference between your generalization and inheritance, where you are going to get some of like 4 marks of question to find out the difference between your generalization and inheritance. We will see what is the difference between your generalization and inheritance. First, let's see about the generalization. As I told you that this is nothing but this is a relationship between your superclass and subclass. Inheritance also the relationship between the superclass and the subclass. But in generalization, what will happen is each subclass is said to be inherit the features of its superclass. Okay, so the subclass will have all the features, all the properties of your superclass. So the child has what all are the properties of a child will be having, all the properties it is going to be getting from the parent class. Okay. So that's the reason the subclass will always inherit the features or properties of your superclass. And this generalization, it is a relationship of is A, that you have to remember. It's a kind of your viva question for the interviews and all. It is a relationship because each instance of a subclass is an instance of a superclass as well. It means that if you are giving the relationship as a is A, then all the instance, those who are present inside the subclass will also be there or will also be the instance of your superclass. That's the reason it is having the relationship of your is A. So now you can tell me like this superclass, what it will do is it will hold all the variety of attributes, operations, and the associations. Okay, so this superclass will hold attributes, operations, and the associations. But what this subclass will do? The subclass will be very specific. Okay, but the superclass will be very general. That's the reason, as the superclass is very general and it will have the many varieties of features, that's the reason this concept is known as your generalization. The subclass will be very specific, okay? It will use only the common attributes or operations or the associations of the superclass. It is not like everything it is going to be utilized from the superclass. Okay, and also if it wants to add his own features also, it can add. Okay, so that is the meaning of your generalization. So in your generalization, if I will merge everything, it means that the superclass will be very general, the subclass will be very specific. The superclass will have the attributes, will have the many features, operations, and associations. But in the subclass, it is going to choose whatever it wants. It will not use everything. Okay. But in your, if I will consider about the superclass, it can add his own features. If it wants to add his own features, that it can do. That's the reason we are calling this relationship as is A, that you have to remember. And one more thing is also the UML notations for a generalization, it is very large hollow arrowhead. It means that how it is going to look whenever you are going to give any of your if you are going to give the link in between superclass to subclass, that time you should use the arrow mark. You can see this kind of arrow mark you have to use. Okay, so this arrow mark will indicate towards the superclass. Okay, you have to give, because the first one, if it is a parent, and then the next subclass, if it is a child, then you have to give this arrow mark towards the parent, not towards the subclass. That you have to remember, because it is a generalization concept. And also one more point, the superclass may directly connect to each subclass, but it will prefer the group of subclass, like a tree. Okay, how we are going to write the tree concept in already in the data structures you have read already. So in that, the same concept we are going to follow in this generalization also. I'll show you the diagram, you can understand that better. So now one more thing is, a generalization, it is a set name which is enumerated attribute that indicates which aspect of an object is being abstracted by a particular generalization. It means that generalization, whatever the name you have taken, suppose I have taken the generalization set name as teacher. So teacher will be act for me as a enum attribute. Enum attribute in the sense, it will have a set of name. Okay, so next what you are going to do? Next, you have to find out the objects, whatever is present inside that enum attribute. So what all are the attributes will be present inside that? The teacher, if I will consider it as a class name, then you can say that male teacher will be there, again female teacher will be there. So what I have done, I have generalized it. Okay, if I will generalize it, that's the reason I'm getting two more classes from this teacher class. So one more class will be my male teacher, one more class will be my female teacher. So what I have done, I have generalized this teacher class. That's the reason the teacher class will be called as your enum attribute. So this is a concept of your generalization, and the teacher class will act like your superclass, and the male teacher and female teacher will act as the subclass of your teacher class. So what I will do is, I'll just move towards the next slide, but here I want to show you one diagram. Here you can see the diagram. This is the PDF of your book, Blaha book. So from that book itself, I will show you the diagram where you can understand the real concept of your generalization and the associations or inheritance. Everything will be together. So here we are going to see, this is the concept of generalization and inheritance. The concept has been written, and I have told you the arrowhead we are going to use, the points. So how we are going to use the points? See here. Otherwise, before going to this, I will do one thing. I'll just do one more diagram for you so that you can understand also. Here I will take the teacher. Okay, what I will do? I will write the teacher. So teacher will have two things. The one will be male teacher and another will be my female teacher. You can keep all these things in a box, rectangular box, and where you can give the arrow marks for both the things. The same way it has been written here, this is one more example where the equipment is the class name. Okay, as like my teacher. Okay, instead of this I can write my teacher. So here this equipment is my class name. So what are the two things I got? I got my male teacher, I got my female teacher. Here what I got? Equipment is my class name. Here I got some of the more class name: pump, heat exchanger and tank. So you can see all has been connected together, and the arrowhead has been given to your super class. So this is my next, this is my enum attributes, enum class. Okay, these all are my attribute names. These all are my generalized classes which has been derived from your equipment class. Next, what I did, you can see here the pump, again it has been classified into three things, that is this pump and this pump. So three generalized category it has been specified. Next, what is happening for heat exchanger? I don't have anything. So what I'm doing for the tank, I have here there are three variety of tanks. So this is a generalized way, and the arrow mark will be towards the up. So in this way, you have to write your you have to write the you have to create the class diagram for your any question whatever has been given. Okay, the method is only you have to specify the class name, which the class name and which has been generalized class name, and in that also particular class if you want to generalize again, you have to give in this way. Okay, and the here whatever has been written, all these things are the attributes of the same. You can write in that way also. Otherwise, here one more way is there. You can see diaphragm pump is there. So what I have done is here, I have taken that one, the name of that pump, the name, the manufacturer, whatever is there. Okay. So whatever I want to specify, where I got this manufacturer, you can see from here also, it has been inherited. It has been generalized. So all these things also I have written, flow rate, this thing, discharge also, you see. Suction pressure also, all these things, whatever is there, that also I have written here. This material concept also I have written, and also I have added my own things. Okay, this is here what you have done. You have described your object diagram. You have written your object diagram of the same, whatever you have described in your class diagram. Also, these things known as your multi-label inheritance, okay? Because why it is known as your multi-label, why the concept is called as the multi-label inheritance? Because we have the labels. You can see this is my first label, this is my second label, this is my third label. It's like that. So the inheritance will have the properties which is going to inherit from your superclass. The subclass will have the properties from the superclass. That's the reason it will have some variety of inheritance. One of the inheritance concept is multi-level. So multi-level in the sense, you should have the multiple labels in that. Here you can see there is more than one labels. So that's the reason this is known as your multi-label inheritance hierarchy with the instances, means all the objects has been written. And also it is known as your generalization, and which has been organized the classes with their similarities and the differences, and structuring the description of the objects. It means that why we are calling the same thing as your generalization concept, because here I have described all my objects with the classes, and also I have shown the similarities and dissimilarities if anything, or differences if anything is there. And what I have done, I have structured it properly. You can see this thing, I have structured it properly with the descriptions. That's the reason this is known as my generalization. There is very like a little difference there in between your generalization and inheritance. So this is one of the diagram, and if I will move towards one more thing, here you can see this is one more diagram, okay, where this is your inheritance also plus your generalization diagram. We will do it we will act on this. So this is all about your generalization and inheritance. If I'll go back to the slide, I will go for here where we are going to use this generalization. So this has three properties, okay, where we are going to use. It will support the polymorphism. Poly means many. So if you are going to have the many variety of your like behaviors or anything is that you want to add, it will support all variety of your polymorphism concept. And also it will have the structure of all the objects to be described. Okay, it will have, that's what we have written. We have described all the diagrams and everything, all the class diagrams through your object diagrams. So that is nothing but it is going to describe all the structures, and also it will enable the if you have written any kind of code, then it is going to reuse the code. Because how it is going to reuse? Because already if you have defined any of the class and with the properties, and same thing if you are writing in the second level of inheritance, that time what it will do, no need to write the same code again. You can copy and paste it. So that is the reuse of code. Then the next point is, the word generalization derives from the fact that the superclass will generalize the subclass. This is main very important line which you need to understand the difference also between generalization and inheritance. Generalization is also known as specialization. That also you should know. The difference will be the generalization, it will be a fact where the superclass will generalize the subclass, okay? But in specialization, what will happen? The subclass will specialize the superclass, just the opposite of the things. So whenever you will do the specialization diagrams, the arrow mark will move towards downward, not towards upward, okay? That is the difference. So but the activity of your generalization and the specialization, it is same. Only the thing is that the arrow mark. Whenever you will write the generalization diagrams, you need to have that superclass generalizes the subclass. But in specialization, the subclass will specialize the superclass. So these two points you need to remember. What will happen in inheritance? Inheritance, it is the mechanism for sharing the attributes, the operations, and the association through your generalization-specialization relationship. It means that whenever you have derived any generalization and specialization categories, that time you give the arrow mark upward or downward, that doesn't matter for inheritance. But what will happen? The properties and the attributes from the superclass, it has to be shareable to the subclass. That is the main purpose of your inheritance. Moving towards the next slide, we will see what you mean by overriding features. The overriding features is nothing but it will act on your subclass. That you have to remember. The overriding concept will act on the subclass, and this subclass will override on your superclass if it is going to define the same name. Suppose in the class, there are two boys, which those who are having the same name. Tomorrow, maybe the first boy can override to the second boy and can say that, I have this name, so you are not existing here because the same name I have and I came to the first to the class. So that is my name. So in that way, what will happen? The first boy is overriding on the second boy. Okay, some kind of features will be there in your diagrams in your classes and all in your class diagrams where the attributes will be the same or the features will be same or the properties will be same. That time what will happen? The subclasses will override the superclasses. And also this overriding feature will have some of the feature which will refine and it will replace the superclass. That also happens. Like the first boy will replace the second boy. Similarly, the overriding features will help the subclass to override the superclass because of that features. Okay. Next one is the methods and default values of attribute can be override, but never override the signature of a feature. It means that if you have defined any kind of your methods or default values of the attributes, that also can be overridable. Okay. That also, like if suppose methods and default values in the sense, suppose in one program you have declared I equals to 0 within a function. Fine. So now next thing what you are going to do is another function also you have written where you have defined as I equals to 0. So what will happen? Suppose in the first bracket that I equals to 0, whatever you have written, that started executing and the I value it got as 5. Now, when the compiler has gone to the second bracket and there also if it is having the I value, what it will do? If the properties and attributes, both the things are same, the values will get at the override there itself. So that is nothing but that is the method and default values where the attributes, if it will have the same thing, it is going to be override. And also one more thing is there, an overriding should preserve the attribute types, the number and the type of arguments to an operation return type. As I told you, the value of your I, the same thing is working out in this point. So what will happen? Always these things will happen in your program. If any attribute types or numbers or arguments, if it is kind of same kind, then what will happen is it is going to replace all these things. Okay, that is the features of your overriding. So this is the navigations of class models. So this navigation concept is nothing but like how you are going to navigate from manually or by writing the expressions from one model to another model. Okay, that we are going to see in this slide. And here it will have the object constraint language. Okay, how you are going to use this object constraint language? You have to follow these points. The first thing is like you should have the attributes, operations, simple associations, qualified associations, generalizations, and filters. So how you are going to find out all these things? Here it is one class diagram. You have to check it out. We will do also these things. So before that, what we will do is we will just go back to the here, and here you can see one more diagram is there. I'll just explain you this diagram, how it is going to be have the generalization concept also, inheritance concept also. Okay, suppose one question will be there where it will have the classes of your geometric figures. So how you are going to find out, how you are going to apply the generalization and your inheritance concept? So what will happen? The first thing is it has been given you that you need to find out the classes of some geometric figures. Okay, so here if I will tell you about the figures, then many things will come to your mind. So now these figures, from where it has come, maybe you can give the name as your diagram, because you need to do the diagrams, right? So don't consider the below things, whatever has been written now. We will consider only the top, that bold part, whatever is there. Then we will come back to this part. So now how I'm going to write? So diagram is also my one class and figure is my another class. So what will be the association link? This is my association link. Okay. And here one to many is there. So one diagram will have many variety of figures. Okay. We can change the figure. We can change the diagram. Any diagram we can, we are going to change it. So now if I want to apply, this is concept of associations I have applied over here. Now if I want to give the name of my generalization concept, I told you that in generalization concept, the arrow mark always it will go to the towards your superclass. So that you have to remember. But if you are applying the specialization, you need to give it to the downward. So now the figure can be any kind of, any dimensionals, right? So the relationship here, I have written dimensionality. Here also you can write the relationship. There is no wrong in that. You can write the relationship also. Diagram has figure also, you can write here has. Here the relationship is like dimensionality. So what variety of dimensionals it is having? Let's take zero dimensional, one dimensional, two dimensional, three dimensional. That is your choice how you are writing. All this diagram has to be the student choice, how you are taking the assumptions and how you are going to write it. So now for my zero dimensionals, I have kept like this. So here everything I have written. These all are my classes, the next level of my classes. As I'm saying you that this is my next level of class. So what will happen? This one will support my multi-level inheritance concept. See, now here in this diagram, three things I'm utilizing. One is your association concept, one is your generalization concept, one now is your multi-level inheritance concept, okay? Now, next, again, if I want to break it and if I want to generalize my classes, what I will do? Let's generalize my two-dimensional. I have polygon, I have circles, okay? So now, if I will generalize my one-dimensional, I'll get line, arc, or spline. If I have zero dimensional, if I want to generalize, I'll get points. So now after this also, again, if you want to generalize the classes, you can do it. Here it won't stop. Okay. So what will happen? All these things have been generalized and inheritance properties also applied. And also you can see I have given all the relationships. If you want to write here the relationship also, you can write down. Then now the next term will come, that object diagram. What we used to do before is The class diagram we used to do separately, then the object diagram we used to do separately. Here what is happening, both the things has been merged together. The attributes, that is nothing but your attributes. So the diagram will have the attributes. What will be the attribute name? That is my name. So the figure will have some of the attributes. Here it has been specified the attribute name. Okay, these are the functions: move, select, rotate, display, all are the functions. Here what I have done, I have written the attribute names. So here also similarly, everywhere the attribute names has been specified. You can write in this way. One, you can take it as your method name. One, you can take your functions name or attribute names in that operations. You can take in that way. Okay. So this is just an example of your class diagram or in a generalized concept, how you are going to do it. So you can get many variety of questions in your exam to to specify your own assumptions, how you are going to do in your exams. So there are many kind of diagrams are there. Here also one more diagram is there, windows circling. You can check the books, there are many diagrams are there. Okay, all these things are known as your class modeling. If the question will come as your prepare a class diagram for each of the group, and sometimes they will specify you the group name also. Okay, like what? Specify the group name in the sense they will tell you, just do the class diagram for each of the class group, where the classes will be diagram, figure, zero dimensional, one dimensional, two dimensionals, and some of the attributes are like move, select, rotate, and display. So that kind of subclasses are there. And this scale applies to this one dimensional, two dimensional figure. And you have to do the diagram. That time you need to do, you have to understand the question and you have to specify in this way. So this is all about your generalization and specialization and inheritance concept.